It's your best work, Basil. You should send it to the Emerald Exhibit.
I'm not sending it anywhere.
You painters astound me. You try so hard to get a reputation, then you just throw it all away.
You're all fool, Basil. There's only one thing worse in this world than being talked about. And that's not being talked about.
I know you're going to laugh, but I can't exhibit it. I've put too much of myself in it.
I see no resemblance between you and this, Adonis. You? You have intellect. But beauty ends where the intellectual expression begins. Your mysterious friend is a brainless, beautiful thing. Don't flatter yourself.
Knowledge and beauty come at a price. Your wealth, Henry. My brains, or fame, whatever they're worth. Dorian Gray's good looks. We'll suffer for what the gods have given us.
Dorian Gray. Is that his name?
Yes, I wasn't going to tell you.
Why not?
You know how I like my secrets? They make life more exciting. You probably think it's silly.
But you forget. I'm married. When my wife and I have dinner, we tell lies to each other with such serious faces. And yet, we never argue. Sometimes I wish we would.
I hate the way you talk about marriage. You know, you're a good man. It's just an act.
Being natural is an act. It's the most irritating one I know. Oh, looks like I'm late for another one of my aunt's ridiculous parties. But before I go, I want the real answer to my question.
What question?
You know which one.
Well, I don't.
Well, then I will tell you.
Oh, God.
Why won't you exhibit Dorian Gray's picture?
I already told you.
No, you didn't. You said there was too much of yourself in it. That makes no sense.
Henry. A picture painted with the heart is a picture of the artist, not the sitter. That's why I can't exhibit it, because it shows my secret.
Basil.
Oh, what secret?
Well,
I'm all expectation, Basil.
You won't even believe me.
I'll believe anything as long as it's incredible.
Well, it is. To me, at least.
He is my art now.
All of the work that I've done after meeting him is the best work of my life.
He's like... harmony between body and soul. It's crazy to think that they're separate things. I see that now.
Basil, you have to introduce me.
Dorian is a way for me to express and create my art. That's all.
Then why not exhibit the picture?
I haven't told him anything about this. Plus, I can't afford to have this piece judged by anyone.
You're wrong. And I'm not gonna argue anymore. How do you get along?
I flatter him all the time. I can't help it.
It won't last forever. Romance makes one so unromantic. Huh? Looks like I missed my aunt's party after all. Dodged a bullet. Now that I think about it, my aunt did mention Dorian to me before. She asked this young musician to perform with her in Easttown. Apparently, he's an exceptional guitarist. She never said he was attractive.
Women have no appreciation for good looks. At least good women don't. I wish I had known it was your friend she was talking about.
I'm glad you didn't.
Why?
Because I don't want you to meet him.
Dorian is my friend. I don't want you to influence him with your dangerous ideas.
I trust you, Henry.
Basil.
Basil, could I borrow this book?
Only after you stand for the portrait again.
Again? I don't even want a portrait of myself. Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't realize you had someone here.
Oh, Dorian, I'd like you to meet an old friend of mine. Meet Dr. Henry Wotton.
Don't call me old.
I would like to finish the painting today. Would you mind leaving, Henry?
Should I go?
Please don't. I can tell Basil's in one of his moods today.
You don't mind, do you, Basil? Don't you always say you want to have someone for your sitters to talk to?
If that's what Dorian wants.
I'm flattered, but I should be going. I have to meet Charles down at the bar.
If he goes, I'll go too. You never say anything when you're painting, and I get so bored.
Oh, it's true. I don't talk or listen when I paint. Please stay, Henry.
What about Charles?
I don't think that will be a problem. Dorian, if you try not to move too much. And ignore everything Henry says. He's a terrible influence.
Are you really a bad influence?
All influence is bad, from a scientific perspective.
Why?
Because. Once influenced, a person does not behave naturally. His virtues are fake. His sins, if there are such things, are borrowed. He becomes nothing more than an echo.
The purpose of life is to grow, to fully realize your own potential. These days, people are afraid. Sure, they're kind, donating to the poor and treating the sick. But it's their own souls that are truly sick and naked. There's no more courage left in our race. Perhaps we never had it. The terror of society is the basis of morals. The fear of God, the secret of religion. These are the laws that govern us.
Yes. Turn your head a little to the right, Dorian.
And yet,
if a man were to live life completely, to give form to every dream, I believe the world would gain such an impulse of joy that we would forget about the days of the Dark Ages and instead return to ancient Greek philosophy.
When his body speaks of passion, he would listen. Denying these natural pleasures would harm the body.
Our lives are punished for our refusals. The only way to get rid of a temptation is to yield to it. Resist.
It has been said that the great events of the world take place in the mind.
It is also the mind where the great sins of the world take place. You, Dorian, with your rose-red youth, rose-white boyhood, you've had passions that make you feel scared, thoughts that terrified you, dreams that have made you blush.
Stop! You're confusing me. Don't talk. Just let me think. Try not to think. I need to take a walk.
Oh, sure. Sorry, I wasn't thinking. I didn't hear a single word Henry was saying. You did make an interesting expression on your face. I suppose it was compliments?
No. Which is probably why I don't believe a thing he said.
You know you believe it.
I think I'll go join Dorian in the garden.
How wise of you.
Nothing can cure the soul but the senses, just as nothing can cure the senses but the soul. You know more than you think you know, and you know less than you want to know. You look upset.
Don't care how I look.
You should.
Why?
Because you're young, and youth is the only thing worth having.
I don't agree.
You don't believe me now. Someday, you will. You charm everyone you meet, but it won't always be like that. You have beauty. Beauty is better than genius. Beauty can't be challenged. You smile. When it's gone, you won't. You only have a few more years left to live. After that, the magic of the world fades. Time is jealous of you, and it will take what it has given. Fear, Dorian. With your personality, there is nothing, nothing you cannot do. Reap the harvest before it is dead.
I'm glad we met.
I am too. I wonder if I always will be.
Always. Women love that word. Always. The only difference between a whim and a romance is that a whim lasts longer.
In that case, I hope our friendship will be a whim.
It's finished.
My God. It's hideous.
I think it's my best work, too.
A masterpiece.
It's really done? What's wrong? Don't you like it?
Of course he does. It's the finest piece of modern art in ages. How much is it?
It's not mine, it's Dorian's.
So sad.
Sad?
I'll grow old, but this picture will be young forever. I wish it was the other way around. I wish I could be young forever and the picture would grow old instead. I'd give anything for that. You were right, Henry. Youth is the only thing worth having. I'd rather die than grow old.
What are you saying?
Why did you paint this? It'll haunt me for the rest of my life! This is your fault. I don't know what you're talking about.
Yes, you do.
You should have left when I asked you to. I stayed when you asked me to.
I can't argue with my two best friends at once.
I don't know what happened, but you both made me hate the finest work I've ever done.
No. It would be murder.
I'm glad you appreciate it, Dorian.
Appreciate it? I'm in love with it. It's a part of me. I can feel it.
Well, once you're dry, I'll have you varnished, framed, and sent to your house.
You two are so odd. Arguing over a picture. You should just let me have it. That silly boy doesn't even want it.
Poor
portrait is mine, and don't call me that.
Don't worry, Dorian. It was yours before I even finished it.
We should go to the opera house tonight. You two have worked up my appetite for drama.
I hate wearing fancy suits. They have no color.
Nowadays, the only color worth wearing is sin.
You shouldn't say that around Dorian.
Which Dorian?
Either.
I'd love to go out tonight. I don't have anything planned.
I did.
I have too much work to do. I'm going to stay here with the real Dorian.
People make such a big deal over fidelity. Young men can't be faithful. Old men can't be faithless. That's all you need to know.
Don't go to the theater, Dorian.
But I just promised I would.
Please. All right. Will I see you tomorrow, though?
You will.
Henry.
Yes, Basil.
Don't forget what I asked you. In the garden.
Of course not. What was that again?
I trust you.
I wish I could trust myself.
Late, as usual.
I'm sorry, I was distracted by a business errand.
Henry, I am so unhappy with you. Why did you talk Dorian out of helping in East Town? He'd have been so valuable to them, the way he plays.
I'm just too selfish. I want him to play for me.
They're so unhappy.
I can sympathize with everything. Except suffering. It's too ugly. There's something so morbid about the sympathy for pain.
But we should be contributing what we can to the public.
Humanity takes itself too seriously, Mr. Burton. It is the world's original sin. If the caveman knew how to laugh, history would have been different.
Well, I'm glad I'm not the only one that feels that way. I have no interest in East Town either. Every time I look into your face, Agatha, I just can't help but feel ashamed.
No wonder you're blushing.
A blush is very becoming, Miss Emily.
When you're young. Tell me how to be young again, Dr. Henry.
Are you really fit to be making such a diagnosis? That's your third drink.
A bottle a day keeps a doctor away. Doesn't seem right.
Nothing Henry says or does seems right. He's just an insincere joke.
An amusing one, though. Go on, Henry. How do I find my youth?
Do you remember any mistakes you made in your early days?
Many, I'm afraid.
Commit them again. Youth returns when follies repeat.
An interesting theory.
A dangerous theory.
I'll have to put it into practice.
Yes. Nowadays, people die from some unnatural common sense. There's only one thing a person never regrets, and that is their mistakes.
Let me come with you.
I'm just going for a walk in the park. Didn't you promise you'd visit Basil?
I'd rather go with you, and promise to talk the whole time. No one talks the way you do.
I've done enough talking for today. I just want to go look at life. You can come look too, if you'd like.
Always late.
Punctuality is the thief of time. Drink, Basil?
No, thanks. I still don't understand why we have to go see that horrible show tonight.
Why don't we go see a tragedy that isn't so... tragic?
Didn't you hear the news? Dorian is engaged.
Husband, you must let me introduce myself. You're as handsome as you are in the pictures.
What pictures?
Oh, Henry must have 27 of them.
Don't be ridiculous.
Well, 26 then. And I saw you at the concert last night.
You did?
Yes. I love Mozart's music, don't you? It's so loud, you can say anything that you want, and nobody will hear. A great advantage, don't you think?
I never talk over music. Not good music, anyways. If the music's bad, then it's my right to drown it out with conversation.
Ah, that's one of Henry's beliefs, isn't it? But don't think that I hate good music, Mr. Gray. It's just that I'm afraid of it is all. It makes me feel too romantic. I've worshipped pianists, you know. Sometimes two at once. I don't know what it is about them. Possibly it's because they're all foreigners. And even if they're not foreigners, they somehow start sprouting an accent or wearing clothes from France. It's really very clever of them. They make me feel so cultural. Henry! I came in here to ask you something important, but I've forgotten what it was. Then I met Dorian here. He's so sweet.
I'm sorry I kept you waiting, Dorian. I was bargaining for a book downtown.
What book?
I read it around your age. It had quite an effect on me at the time. It's the story of a young Parisian who despises his current society. He lives in isolation, realizing all the thoughts and passions of every century before his own.
Realizing passions. How wonderful. Well, goodbye. I promised Emily I'd go into town with her. I suppose I'll be seeing you later tonight, my dearest husband?
Of course, my love. That was Victoria. Never marry a blonde, Dorian.
You're so sentimental. Thanks.
Never marry at all. Men marry because they're tired, and women marry because they're curious. Both are disappointed.
I'm too in love to marry. It's one of your aphorisms. I'm putting it into practice, just like everything else you say.
Who are you in love with?
Her name is Sybil Vane.
Never heard
of her. You will someday. Everyone will. She's a genius. An actress.
Where did you meet her?
In Fair Verona.
But the play was terrible. I nearly got up and left.
But then, Juliet. She was the loveliest thing I'd ever seen. Even you would agree if you saw her. And the way she spoke, with such passion, nearly brought tears to my eyes. Thank you. Your voice and the voice of Sybil Vane are two things I will never forget. When I close my eyes, I can hear both of them. Each one says something different. I don't know which one to follow. Why shouldn't I love her? I've been back to the theater every night since then.
and seen her perform in every age and costume. She's more than just a girl. One night she's Rosalind, the next Imogene.
When is she Sybil Vane?
Never.
Congratulations. How well have you gotten to know her?
I knew you'd act this way. Sybil's more than a person. She's sacred.
It's only the sacred things that are worth touching. So, I presume you know her fairly well then?
Yes. On the third night, I finally met her. We were so nervous. She called me Prince Charming.
How flattering.
There's something so childlike about her. She's poor. Well, she always has been. The stage is her life. To her, I'm just another character in a play. Henry, I love her. She means the whole world to me. Why didn't you tell me the only thing worth loving is an actress?
Because I've loved so many of them.
I want you and Basil to come see her perform. You won't be disappointed.
Engaged? To who?
Some little actress or other.
Dorian's too smart to rush into something like that.
And he's too wise not to do something foolish now and then.
Marriage is not something you do now and then. Henry.
People go through weddings like they do bed sheets. And that's not a coincidence.
I cannot believe you're joking about something like this.
I didn't say he was married, I said he was engaged. There's a difference.
Engaged? I just can't believe it. I can't.
Please don't be upset, just be happy for me.
You don't approve of this, do you?
I don't approve or disapprove of anything now. Dorian wants to marry an actress? Why not? I hope he makes her his wife. Loves her for 6 months. And then leaves her for some other beautiful girl. Yes. It'd make an interesting study.
Don't say that. Nobody would feel worse than you to see Dorian's life fall apart.
I love it when I see you act, Sybil. Mr. Isaacs has been so helpful to us. If it weren't for his theater, I honestly don't know where we would be right now.
And I don't know what I would do without Prince Charming. I love him, Mom.
Don't be stupid, Sybil. How many times do you have to make stupid mistakes before you realize that you're stupid and you really shouldn't be doing these impulsive things anymore? It's really just downright mad.
No, I love him, but what does he see in me? I mean, I can't explain it, but when I'm with him, I don't feel lower than him. I feel so proud. Did you love Dad the same way?
Ow!
Damn. I'm sorry. Okay, I know it hurts for you to talk about him, but that's only because you loved him so much. I'm as happy with my prince as you were 20 years ago.
You don't even know his name. Sybil, and your brother is leaving today. Still, if he has money.
Please, just let me be happy.
Of course I will, you wonderful, talented girl.
Save some of those hugs for me.
I thought you hated hugs, you little bear.
I make an exception for my little sister.
I'll miss you, James. I wish you didn't have to go.
It's for the best. I can't stand it here anymore. And if I come back...
When you come back.
When I come back. Then I can pay off all of our debts. And you wouldn't have to act anymore.
Don't forget about us, James.
You're more likely to forget about me.
How could I?
You have a new friend, I hear? He visits you at your dressing room every night?
Tonight's the night you will both meet my true love. I know it's sudden, but all the best things are. Drink, Basil?
No, thanks. Dorian, put that down. You're barely 20.
It's a special occasion.
One I should have been told about sooner.
Dorian, why don't you tell us what happened?
I don't trust him.
You haven't even met him.
Neither has Mom. You don't even know his name, Sybil.
His name is Prince Charming, and he's wonderful.
He wants to keep you to himself.
Well, then I don't ever want to be free.
Be careful.
To look at him is to trust him.
You're crazy.
Because I'm in love! One day you'll fall in love too, and you'll know how it feels.
I swear to God, if he hurts you, I'll kill him.
Stop it, James. Just don't ruin our last afternoon together with your temper. You're going to a new world, and I found one. Things are gonna be different for both of us now. Better than ever. Be happy for me. Please.
Last night I met with her again. And we kissed. I can't even begin to describe how I felt. I'm in love with all the greatest heroines of romance. I don't know why I'm telling you this. But I can't help it. I was right to give my love to a true artist. Wasn't I, Basil?
I suppose. When did you mention marriage?
What?
Perhaps you forgot all about it.
It wasn't like a business transaction, Henry. I didn't make a formal proposal. I just told her that I loved her, and she said she wasn't good enough to be my wife. Can you imagine? The whole world is nothing compared to her.
Mother. I have a question for you, and I think I have a right to know. Were you and Dad ever really married?
No, we weren't.
That bastard.
I knew he was too busy to settle down with us, but we loved each other. Please don't be mad. If he were still alive today, he would take care of us, he would.
Let me guess. He was probably pretty well off, too. Like this drifter that Sybil's running off with. Just promise me you won't let her ruin her life
like me.
Sybil has a mother. I didn't.
I'm sorry. I didn't know what to do. This man that Sybil's in love with, if he breaks her heart, just promise me you'll take care of her.
Of course, of course.
You're not really interested in spending your entire life with this girl, are you?
Don't, Henry, you're upsetting him.
I'm just curious.
It's impossible to be mad at you, Henry. When you see her, you'll realize that anyone who breaks Sybil's heart would be more monster than man. She makes me forget all your poisonous theories.
You'll always like me, Dorian. Yes, we'll always be good friends.
Sybil.
Remember what I asked you.
What did he ask?
Oh, nothing important. It's nothing.
Let's go. When you see Sybil Vane, you will learn something new about life.
I've seen everything. But I'm always ready for a new emotion. Coming, Basil?
No, I'll meet you there.
Thank you.
Don't worry. Once she's on stage, everything changes. When she speaks, anything is possible. You feel unified with everyone here.
I hope not.
Two households, both alike in dignity. How dare you? This is a historic tragedy.
You got that right.
Sure hope this is the abridged version.
Don't worry, Dorian. I believe in her.
Thanks, Basil.
She's beautiful,
but
she can't act. Let's get going.
I'm going to stay. Sorry for wasting your time.
Let's go, Basil. Never was there a tale of more woe than this of Juliet and her Romeo.
Juliet.
Yes, are you sick? You should never act when you're sick. It was painful to watch.
Don't tell me you haven't noticed.
Noticed what? How many people walked out? You embarrassed me in front of some of my closest friends. I could barely stomach sitting through the whole show.
Dorian, I thought you knew. I used to believe that the world really was a stage. All my life, I've done nothing but pretend. Love with my prince, and I opened my eyes for the first time and saw what love really is. The stories aren't real. I can't act anymore. You're my life now, Dorian. My life on the stage is over. I might fake an emotion for art, but when you hold me, take me away. Take me anywhere, Dorian. I love you.
My love is dead.
What? Dorian, don't be silly.
You used to be everything to me. We could have loved each other forever in the dreams we made. But now, My love is dead and buried. You're just a third-rate actress with a pretty face.
Why are you acting like that?
Acting? I'll leave that up to you. You're so good at it.
Dorian,
don't touch me.
I only did badly because I was thinking of you the whole time, but I can try better, I promise. Just don't be angry.
I never want to see you again.
How the heck could you say that?
Goodbye.
I'm so sorry, Dorian. Just try not to think about it too much.
You mean Sybil Vane?
Can I come in?
Of course, of course.
Did you go see Sybil after the play?
Yes.
Thought so. And did you make a scene?
It was bad. But I'm not sorry. I learned a valuable lesson about myself.
I'm so glad you feel that way.
I want to be good, Henry. I have a stronger conscience now. And it's a divine thing. Just like one.
An artistic basis for ethics, Dorian. But how will you begin?
By marrying Sybil Vane.
Marrying Sybil Vane? But Dorian...
I already know what you're going to say. Probably something terrible about marriage. Just don't. 2 days ago, I made a promise. I don't intend to break it now.
Dorian. Sybil Vane is dead. It was in the news this morning.
No.
The police are already doing an investigation. You can't get mixed up in it.
It's not true.
You didn't tell anybody besides Sybil Vane your real name, so that should keep anyone from getting you involved.
An investigation? Did she... How did she...
It wasn't an accident. She drank some kind of poison. She She died instantly.
I murdered Sybil Vane. This is the first love letter I've ever written, and it's addressed to a corpse. Feels so long ago now. When we talked, I thought she was shallow. I'm the shallow one. What am I gonna do? She was the only one who could save me.
Don't let it worry you, Dorian. The marriage would have been a failure anyways.
I wanted to make up for what I did. What is it you always say about good resolutions?
They're always made too late.
This whole thing just feels like the ending to some terrible play.
You said once that being with Sybil Vane, it's like being with all the greatest heroines of romance. That she came to life on the stage.
She'll never come to life again.
That's true. She's played her last part. But she's always been some sort of phantom to you. Existing only in shadows. Mourn for Ophelia, if you like. Lay a flower on the tomb of Juliet's body. But don't waste your tears for Sybil Vane. She never really lived, so she couldn't die either. She's no more real than the stories of Shakespeare. Don't let it worry you. It's been a marvelous experience, that's all. Nothing you can do about it now.
So well. And you're right. Let's not talk about her again. It's in the past.
I brought you something.
What is it?
It's the book I bought downtown. Cost me a pretty penny, but I think you should have it. I also got you an Italian pipe. Thought you might like it. Well, I should get going. I'll see you at the club tonight.
Dorian?
Oh, thank God. I heard about Sybil. I came to visit you yesterday. Where were you?
I was at the club last night with Henry.
But Sybil's dead. Her family is in mourning and you're out having drinks?
Stop! I won't hear it. What's past is past.
You call yesterday the past.
If you had come sooner, you would have seen me in tears. I suffered, Basil. It was terrible. I had plans to make it up to her before I even realized she was dead. But that's over now. If you want to comfort me, then teach me to forget it. To be the spectator of one's own life, as Henry says, is to escape the suffering of it. I was a boy when you met me. But I'm a man now. New ideas, new beliefs. Don't hate me for it. You're still my friend.
Won't you come visit again? I haven't painted anything since you've been gone.
No. And I'll never be painted again.
Why?
Don't you like my paintings? And why is my greatest work covered by a curtain?
The lighting wasn't right.
The lighting was perfect. What are you talking about? Let me see.
You can't. I won't let you. I swear to God, if you touch that curtain, our friendship is over.
Dorian!
Don't speak!
What is the matter with you? I'm going to have to see it eventually anyhow. It's part of my exhibit in the fall.
You're going to exhibit it?
Yes.
But you said you'd never exhibit it. You said that to me and Henry the day you finished it. We both have a secret. Tell me yours, and I'll tell you mine. Why wouldn't you exhibit the picture? I think I have a right to know.
Have you noticed anything strange about the picture? Something you didn't like? I thought so. Don't talk, just let me explain. When I first met you, I changed. I wanted you all to myself. Even when we were apart, when I painted, you were there. But then one day I decided to create a masterpiece. In the end, I was afraid that what I had created revealed my secret obsession with you. That's why I didn't exhibit the picture. Then I realized that it doesn't hold my secrets. It's just an image. Art's too abstract to reveal that much. I wanted you to be the star of my exhibition. But perhaps I was right. It reveals too much. Will you ever let me see the painting again?
Never.
I don't suppose we'll be seeing too much of each other after this.
What are you talking about? All you told me is that you liked me too much? That's not even a compliment.
It wasn't a compliment. It was a confession.
A disappointing one.
What did you expect? There isn't anything else you saw in the portrait. Is there?
No. There's nothing else.
Are you sure you won't let me paint you again?
Never.
That's too bad. Goodbye, Dorian.
Thank you.
You're awfully quiet today, Mr. Gray.
Didn't sleep well.
But you left so early last night. Did you just go home?
No, I went home late.
So you went to the club then?
Yes. No, I just went for a walk. I don't remember. You're so curious tonight. Why do you always want to know what it is I'm trying to forget?
I just can't help myself, Dorian. Dorian?
Basil! I just came by to tell you I'm leaving for Paris.
I haven't seen you in ages. You'll be back soon, won't you?
Actually, I'm going to be gone for 6 months. Could we talk a minute?
Of course. Drink, Basil?
No, thank you. I'd like to talk to you about something serious.
Nothing is serious these days. At least nothing should be.
Well, this is. I think you should know that people have been saying horrible things about you.
I don't want to know.
You should. I don't believe anything they're saying, of course. I can't when I look at your face. But.
But.
The Dorian I hear about is not the same Dorian I know. But I wonder, do I really know you?
You'll see it for yourself. After all, you're the only one who should. It's your work. And nobody'd believe you, even if you told them.
Everything I said was for you. You know I've always been close.
Don't touch me. Just finish what you were saying.
I just want an answer to all of this. If you tell me that they're all lies, then I'll believe you.
I have a journal upstairs. I write in every day. It never leaves the room.
I don't want to read. I just want an answer.
That can only be given to you upstairs. Follow me. You'll get your answer. Are you sure you want to know?
Yes.
God's the only one who can look at a man's soul. Pull back that curtain, and you'll see mine.
You're just trying to scare me.
If you won't do it, I will.
God, what the hell is that thing?
When you first met me, I was a boy. You were obsessed. You taught me about the importance of my good looks. Then you introduced me to Dr. Henry. You taught me about the importance of youth. Then you painted my picture. In it I saw my greatest strength. I did not want to lose that. Ever. I don't know if I regret it. But I made a wish. A prayer of sorts.
Impossible.
What is impossible?
This isn't my painting.
No. But it is your work. Can't you see the romance in that?
I don't see anything but evil. The face of a monster.
The face of my soul.
What have I been loving? This is what you really look like? It's punishing.
punishment for us all. Pray, Dorian. Please, lead us not into temptation. Forgive our sins.
It's too late.
It's never too late. Please, Dorian, pray. Though your sins may be as scarlet, I will make them white as snow.
That means nothing to me.
Don't say that. You've already done enough. Can't you see how disgusting that is? Up there looking down at us like that? I can't take it.
Come in! Alan, upstairs there is a dead man sitting in a chair. He has been dead for 10 hours. Don't get up. Who he is and why he died is not important. What I need you to do is gather your equipment and go up there.
Stop! Gray, I don't want to know. You can keep your secrets to yourself. They don't interest me anymore.
Alan, please! You're the only one who can do this. You're a scientist. I need you to go upstairs and destroy that thing and all of his belongings. No one will miss him. He's supposed to be in Paris.
Do you honestly think that I would ruin my reputation for your sick plans?
So you really won't?
Of course not! I don't want anything to do with it! Whatever happens to you, you deserve.
It was a murder, Alan. I killed him. But you don't know what he made me suffer. Whatever my life is now, he caused it. He didn't mean to. But that can't be helped now. This, however, can be helped by you.
Murder? Is that what it's come to? I won't say anything.
I just need you to do an experiment. You perform them all the time. Why is this corpse any different? Please, Alan. We were friends once.
Don't talk about it. Those days are dead.
So is he. But he's still here. You're here.
I will never help you.
Sorry, Alan, but you gave me no choice. I already wrote the letter. You see who it's addressed to? I tried to spare you. You were cold. And I let you be. Until now. Now it's my turn to set terms. You know what has to be done. Don't leave a trace.
saved me, Alan.
I won't ever forget.
Neither will I.
Get up.
What do you want?
Revenge.
I don't even know you.
You killed my sister.
Sister?
An actress. Too young to die.
I don't even know her.
Liar! He's called Prince Charming. Just like you. It's not coincidence. I've met my fate. Now meet yours.
Wait. How long has it been? Since she died.
18 years.
Look at my face. I'm 20. The man you're looking for.
Gun away and go home. It's what Sybil would have wanted.
There's something different about you today. I can't quite put my finger on it.
I told you.
I'm going to be good from now on. I'm changed.
Don't change, Dorian. You're perfect.
Anything interesting going on in town?
There's so much news swarming about. There's, of course, my divorce. Then Alan's suicide. Now the disappearance of a famous artist.
What do you think happened to him?
I haven't the slightest idea. Basil wants to hide. That's his business. And if he's dead, I don't want to think about it. Death is vulgar. Like the man my wife ran off with. That bastard. My life is so empty without her.
Henry, do you think Basil was murdered? I miss him.
Basil murdered? Not a chance. Nobody hated him. He was too boring to hate. The only time he really interested me was when he told me he was obsessed with you. How did you keep yourself so young, Dorian? I would do anything to be young again. Except exercise. Get up early or act respectable. The horrible thing about old age is not the fact that you're old, but that you're actually quite young. What a life you've had, Dorian. You never held anything back. You've experienced everything. But yet you're still the same. You haven't let time take what's rightfully his. Your life is your art. You've taken yourself to music. A day to you is like a song.
Yes. Life has been great, Henry. But you mustn't say things like that to me anymore. Things like that book had taught me. You must promise me that you'll never give that book to anybody else. It does nothing but cause trouble.
You really have changed. But it's no use. You are who you are. And I am what I am. There's no changing that.
Bye, Henry. Tomorrow I'll be even better than I am today. Your ideas have been wonderful. It's time for me to move on.
Seems like you've already have. Goodbye, Dorian Gray.
so sad.
Sad?
I'll grow old, but this picture will be young forever. I wish it was the other way around. I wish I could be young forever and the picture would grow old instead. I'd give anything.